Hello and welcome. Today we're going to craft a tissue paper rose ball. And for this you need a balloon, some newspaper, tissues, brush, glue that turns transparent when dry, hot glue, scissors, and a straightened paper clip. I'm starting off with filling the balloon with air, and then tearing stripes from the newspaper. Since the newspaper was closed when the stripes was torn, I have to remove or cut off the fold. After that, I'm cutting the pieces into three equal sizes. And then gluing the newspaper to the balloon and letting each layer dry. After roughly three layers, I have crafted a hard shell on the balloon. When the third layer has dried, then you can feel that the paper can support itself and not relying on the balloon, it's time to pop the balloon to remove it from the inside. Since there's going to be gaps between the rose petals, and we doesn't want to show that the ball itself is made of newspaper, we're going to apply one or two layers of tissue, the same tissue we're going to create roses with. And this is done with the same method as we did with the newspaper. And you doesn't need to cover the whole ball with tissue, since the bottom is going to be covered with a flower pot. When these two layers has dried, we can use a skisser to remove the extra material from the bottom. To craft a rose, we need to cut off stripes that are roughly 5 to 6 cm wide. Then fold 1/3 of the tissue to create a sharp edge for the rose petals. I'm then placing my straightened paper clip on one of the edges, roughly 1 cm from the edge, and then folding it over the paper clip. Then place the clip close to the fold and start rolling until the whole fold is rolled in around the paperclip. You can here see the type of fold I'm using to create the petals, but of course in a much smaller scale. I'm starting off by placing my fingers very close to the tip the petals, and after one whole turn I'm moving my fingers down roughly to the middle of the tissue paper and starting to create larger petals for the rose. This may not work the first time you try, but after a few tries and experimentation of how you're going to create them, you're going to see that it's rather easy to do. After that, the whole tissue is wrapped around the paper clip. I can remove the clip and then twist the rose and the rest or extra material from the tissue to create a tight seal. Make sure that the rose doesn't loosen itself. An easy way to create a good tight fit between the flower pot and roses is to start with the base layer, or the one nearest or closest to the flower pot. I'm going around the whole bottom and then moving upwards until the whole ball is covered with the tissue roses. This crafting took me around 5 hours to complete, and this is without the waiting time for the glue to dry. If you like this video, you may like some of my other videos as well, which you can find here to the right. And you can also, of course, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow.